Actually, two quite interesting topics pop up. The first thing we've asked people, would you be open for mobility based on a subscription-based model instead of actually owning a car? 82% of the people have mentioned that they're still not open for that model. And it's quite surprising, actually, especially when we look at the Dutch market, where there's a brand called Link & Co, which is quite successful, basically selling cars based on a subscription model. The other thing that's also quite interesting is we've also asked people, when picking a new car, would you favor an EV version and a car based on a combustion engine? There we see the outcome being still 50-50. Again, quite surprising. I would have expected more people to pick an EV. However, the old argument of range anxiety is also something that plays in the minds of the people. And that's the reason why they still favor a combustion engine a little bit more than an electric car. I think our clients should invest more in explaining to the clients what the benefits are in terms of flexibility and in terms of costs, etc., making such a subscription-based model more attractive. On the other hand, we also do see car prices rising quite rapidly. So based on that, also looking at the future, accessibility to new cars, to mobility, will be more and more based on subscription-based models instead of people buying a car by themselves. We need to improve the sales of EVs. And in that case, we still see the old argument of range anxiety. In order to cure that, I think not so much in the Netherlands, but more across Europe, I think companies, but also governments should invest a little bit more in the infrastructure, taking away the range anxiety and therefore also improving the sales of EVs. I'm proud that we as Deloitte are helping our clients strategically with this transformation in the automotive industry. By helping them, we truly are accelerating also this transformation in the automotive industry.